Alright, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ma'am and all of my friends. Thank you so much for the time that has been given for my group. We are from the 6th group, and before we are going to explain about our material, school-based management. The honorable our lecturer in this subject matter, ma'am Nursiani Marwal, is our lecturer in educational management lecture. So in this occasion, we are conscious with explaining the topic school-based management, and I'm going to explain for us about definition of school-based management and the purpose of the school-based management. The first is about definition of school management. School-based management is a new paradigm of education which provides broad autonomy at the school level, community involvement within the framework of national educational policies. So in this school-based management, so the policy maker gave the school policy to give have same like decentralization, so the school can give something decision in their school. In general, according to Edmond S. quoted by Subsurtor, this is a new alternative in the management of education, which emphasized the independence and creative of the school. Nurkolis said the school-based management is alternative form of school as a result of decentralization of education. So it is same with decentralization. So school-based management is the product of decentralization, where the government gave the school opportunities to make a decision in the curriculum role or in the school role. In general also, a school-based quality improvement management can be defined as a management model that gives school greater autonomy and encourages participatory decision-making that directly involves all school members such as teacher, student, principals also, employers, parents, and student. So in making decision, all the school members can have a meeting to make a decision the better in the school also. Furthermore, the term school management is often juxtaposed with the term school administration also. In this regard, there are three different views. First, interpreting administration more broadly than management. Management is the essence of administration also. Second, seeing management more broadly than administration. Administratorian is the core of manager. And third is who assumes the management is synonymous with administration. So based on their main function, the term management as administration have the same function, namely planning, organizing, directing, coordinating, controlling, and also evaluating. It is according to GAVR 1989 suggests that education management means as a systematic and comprehensive cooperation process in order to realize the goals of national education. So that's about definition of school-based management. So the conclusion of school-based management that we have to get here is that school-based management is is the same product as decentralization, where the government or the policymaker give the school opportunities to make decision, to take the decision in making the curriculum or maybe something the role in the school. Now we are going to the purpose of school-based management. There are several purpose of school-based management. The first is improving the quality of education through independence and school initiatives in managing and empowering available resources. So that is very clear that this is make the give opportunity to school to improve their quality in education also. The second is about increase the awareness of school residents and the community in the implementation of education through joint decision making also. The third is about increase the responsibility of school to parents, community, and government regarding the quality of their school. And the last is increase healthy competition between school regarding the quality of education to be achieved. The authority that rests on the school is the core active base, the management, which is considered to have a high level of effective and provide several advantages, including the first is about school policies and authorities have a direct influence on students, parents, and also in the teacher. The second is aims how to utilize the local resource also. The third is about effective in choosing student and attendance, learning outcomes, repetition rate, default rate, teacher morale, and also school climate. And the last about, there are is a common concern for decision making, empowering teachers, school management, school regarding and planning change also. So this is all about the purpose and also definition about school-based management. For the next explanation, it will explain by the next presenter. That's all, thank you.
Hello everyone, thank you for the time that has been given to me. I'm Elisandi Telamanua. In this time, I will continue explain our material today that is about school-based management. And in this case, I will focus to explain for us about the benefit of school-based management and the implementation of school-based management. And for the first, I will explain about the benefit of school-based management. There are four the benefit of school-based management. For the first is, based on local conditions, school can improve the welfare of teachers so that they can concentrate more than on their duties. So with S is a school-based management, the school can improve the welfare of teachers so the teacher can more focus to do their duties or their obligation. The second is freedom in managing research and in involving the community to participate, encourage the professionalism of school principals in their roles as manager and school leaders. So here, with a school-based management, can give the freedom to teacher, can give the freedom to the lead of the school to manage, to lead their school more better. And the third is teachers are encouraged to innovate. So here, with school-based management, the teachers can encourage, can free to give innovate to develop their school. And the last is the school's responsiveness to local needs increase and ensures that educational service can meet the demands of the schools, community, and students. So here, with school-based management, the schools can fast to respond to local needs and increase and ensures that educational service meet the demands of the schools, community, and students. Alright, now I will continue to explain for us about the implementation of school-based management. School-based management has been instituted in this place like the UK. We are more than 25,000 schools have participated, have practical it for more than a decade. Or like new Zealand or Victoria, Australia, or in some of the larger school system in Canada and that United States, where there has been a similar experience for more than a decade. A school-based management practice in this place appear to be irreversible. An indication of the scale and scope of interest in school-based management was on the agenda at the meeting of Minister of Education of the APEC countries in Chile in April 2004. Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation is a network of 2001st centuries containing one third of the world's population. The theme of the meeting was quality of in education, and governments is one of four subtemps. Nah, particular attention is directed to decentralization. The ministers strongly endorse school-based management as a strategy in education reform, but also agreed on aspects of centralization, such as a framework for accountability. And according to a mention 1989, they recognized that the settings will vary from country to country, reflecting the uniques of each settings. Nah, school-based management has many shadows of meaning. It has been implemented in different ways and for different purpose and at different rates in different places. Even then, more basic concepts of school and management are different, as a different cultures and values that underline the efforts of policymakers and practitioners. However, the same reasoning across place where school-based management is implemented is that there is increased authority and responsibility at the school level, but still within a centrally defined framework to ensure that a meaningful system is maintained. One important implication is that school leaders must have the capacity to make decisions on significant matters relating to school operation, and recognizing and adopt the elements set cut in the central framework applicable throughout the school. From the start, the central and local governments should be supportive of SBM idea. They must trust principals and school boards to determine how to achieve educational goals in each school. It is important to have a written agreement stating the standards that will be used as a basis for assessing school accountability. Each school needs to compile an annual performance report that includes how well the school is performing in its efforts to achieve its goals and objectives, how the school is using its research, and what are the next plans. It is necessary to provide training in areas such as group dynamics, problem solving and decision making, conflict management, presentation techniques, stress management, and interpersonal communication in group. This training is intended for all parties involved in the school and community members, especially in the early stage of implementing SBM or school-based management. To meet a job challenge, principals are likely to need additional leadership training. In the other words, implementing school-based management requires the following. The first is SBM must have the support of all staff. So here, school-based management have a role to support all of staff in the school. The second is SBM is more likely to be successful. It is implemented gradually. So here the school-based management has in implementing for school. When we use school-based management, it is be successful in implementing gradually. The third is schools and office staff must receive training in its application, at the same time learning to adapt to new roles and communication channels. The fourth is budget support for training and time for for staff to meet regularly should be provided. And the last is, central and local governments should delegate authority to school participants, and school principals in turn share the authority with teachers and parents. Nah, there are some of the obstacles that may be encountered in the implementation of school-based learning. The first is not interest to get involved. Nah, it means that there are some people who do not want additional work other than the job they are currently doing. They are not interested in participating in activities that they think only add to the burden. Nah, school board members should spend more time on planning and budgeting matters. As a result, principals and teachers do not have much time left to think about other aspects of their work. Not all teachers will be interested in budgeting process or will not want to devote their time to it. The second is not efficient. Nah, why school-based management is not efficient? Because participatory decision making is sometimes frustrating and often slower than in authoritative ways. School board members must be able to work together and focus on assignment, not on their things. The third is group mind. After some time together, the members of the school board will likely become more and more cohesive. On the other hand, it has a positive impact because they support each other. On the other hand, the cohesiveness causes members to be compromising just because they don't feel comfortable have a different opinions with other members. It is this time that the school board begins to contract a group mind. This is dangerous because the decision take are likely to unrealistic. The fourth is requires training. Stakeholders are likely to have no experience in applying this complex and participatory model. They most like lack the knowledge and skill about the nature of SBM and how it works, decision making, communication, and etc. The fifth is confusion over new roles and responsibilities. The parties involved are likely to have been very conditioned to the working demand they have been involved in. The implementation of SBM changes the roles of responsibilities of interest parties. Sudden changes are likely to cause shock and confusion, so that they are hesitant to assume decision making responsibilities. And the last is coordination difficulties. Every application of a complex model that includes various activities requires effective and efficient coordination. Without it, various activities will run away from the school goals. Alright, that's all about my explanation, and thank you.
Okay, thank you for the time given to me. My name is Fatima Maru. I will continue part A. Strategy for improving the quality of education throughout the implementation of school-based management atau strategi peningkatan mutu pendidikan. dilakukan melalui penerapan manajemen. Nah, jadi di sini dijelaskan bahwa dalam strategi peningkatan mutu ini merupakan model ataupun pengelolaan yang memberikan otonomi atau kewenangan dan tanggung jawab lebih besar kepada sekolah, misalnya memberikan fleksibilitas dan mendorong partisipasi secara langsung. Nah, salah satu strategi untuk menciptakan persyaratan yang kondusif untuk menerapkan manajemen berbasis sekolah yaitu salah satunya yang pertama, peningkatan kapasitas dan komitmen seluruh warga sekolah termasuk masyarakat dan orang tua siswa, dan yang kedua upaya penguatan kepala sekolah. Nah, jadi di sini strategi tersebut ini dapat menciptakan persyaratan yang kondusif sehingga misalnya peningkatan kapasitas ini dapat berkomitmen berjalan dengan lancar dan juga harus didukung oleh kepala sekolah. Selanjutnya manajemen peningkatan mutu sekolah. Nah, artinya di sini peningkatan mutu ataupun manajemen peningkatan mutu sekolah ini adalah merupakan suatu metode peningkatan mutu yang bertumpu pada sekolah itu sendiri, yaitu misalnya menerapkan seperangkat teknik berdasarkan ketersediaan data kuantitatif dan kualitatif secara memperdayakan seluruh komponen sekolah untuk terus meningkatkan kapasitas dan kemampuan organisasi sekolah dalam memenuhi kebutuhan mahasiswa dalam masyarakat. Okay, that's what I expect.